we're in the Robert Gillow pub in Lancaster City Centre, which on Saturday night was a refuge for loads of people who were trapped in the city centre on a night out. With me, I have the man being branded a hero, Mark Cutter. Can you tell me a bit about what you did as the landlord here on Saturday?
Right. Somebody was sending Kat a Facebook message saying, well, where do we go? What can we do? And we realised there was no news, there was no information, nothing on any social media or any branding. What do? If you're stuck? Because the bridges were slowly going out one by one. And I said, right, until we get a better answer to this question, people can come here. You know, we're open, we've got space, we've got food, we've got coffee. So I picked up the phone about 10 p.m, this was lights are still on, rang the police headquarters and said, bring people here, we will act as a refuge, we'll stay here open all night, my staff are going to do it, we can stay open until you need us to close. Just keep bringing us people and we'll sort you out.
We all came on duty as normal, and my role as a licensing officer was to come on and do my normal night safe duties, which is obviously to check the pubs and clubs are safe and everybody's having a nice night out and there's no trouble. Obviously, as I came on duty, I realised the flood levels were getting higher and there was a serious concern about the River Lune. And at that stage, I just booked in with the rest of the troops, if you like, and assisted in dealing with it.
Then the power went off.
But a lot of them thought there was a terrorist attack going on. Power went off, and they just evacuated at clubs in seconds and just went out onto the streets and wanted to go home.
We quickly marshalled the staff, got candles out on all the tables. But actually, my thinking was, right, people are asking what to do. No one's got an answer. I've got a space. The police... I've not got time to work out an answer to this question.
There has to be a special mention, really, to Mark Cutter, who's the DPS for this pub. At times, there was 50 people sleeping in here. He had through his doors over 200 people who he fed and watered at no cost to themselves. He did it all out of his own pocket. Without Mark putting this place up as a place of refuge, I think the police would have struggled as to where we could have put everybody, really.
The police were bringing us, radioing us at 5 in the morning, saying, can we bring someone? We've got 8 people we've just evacuated off the quay with nowhere to go. We're dropping people off wrapped in tinfoil and shaking a young woman with a cat that had been rescued. And there were some musicians who just played the piano till about 4 o'clock in the morning to keep everyone calm. And we just tried to hold the city together.
So now, like 5-6 days on, obviously you've got a lot of the police officers who were out on duty that
yes.
night in your pub. How are you feeling now?
I'm really pleased about that, to be honest. I mean, one of the nice things was one of them who's here did actually pull up at the front door at 4 a.m. on Saturday night, soaking wet because he'd been riding around in the boat fishing people out of the river, and just gave me a hug and said, thank you for doing this.
The fire service obviously came down to assist at the scene. The water levels were up to the bottom of King Street, and they obviously deployed a dinghy with two officers from the fire service, and I was in the boat with them, assisting with clearing cars, checking premises, people that were stranded, and going around the bus station, which was under 6 foot of water at the time.
Facebook went down, mobile phones went down, Twitter went down, everything went down, and all we had was normal radio, so all people could listen to. I've spoken to a lot of people who actually got into the cars and listened to the radio to find out what was going on.
I mean, the Bay itself, for example, became our emergency broadcast station.
The Bay Radio, we have to sing their praises. They were absolutely amazing to yourself and all your staff. And then you look at all the emergency service that worked just constantly, didn't go home. You have to look at all the local businesses. I mean, the list is endless, really. There was people putting stuff on social media, getting messages out there that they were putting their places up for a place of refuge. They were putting on free food, a bed for the night, everything. They were just amazing.
It was just a real feeling that we're all pulling together. And I just, for me, that's why I've always liked this city. And it's one of the reasons I care about the city is, in general, people pull together and try and do something.